I'm gonna give you three keys behind the first turn and the hammer throw, and we're gonna start right now. What's up, everybody? It's Dane Miller from throwsuniversity.com. If this is your first time to the channel and you're interested in becoming a better thrower, you want to take your throwing to the next level, you want to improve your glide, you want to improve your spin, you want to improve your discus, make sure you like, subscribe, you ring that notification bell, and we're starting with the hammer throw work today. So oftentimes in the hammer throw, we see guys start to lose balance as soon as they're getting out of their winds. They forget the basic principles behind the hammer throw. And it's very easy to see guys and women come out of those winds a little bit too aggressive, especially if we're talking about the four turn hammer throw. So we've got to think about those three key aspects to establishing good momentum and good setup as we're coming out of that first turn. So that first key aspect behind the first turn in the hammer throw is that we've got to look at it as an extension of our winds, especially if we're talking about the four turns. So when we're coming out of the first and second wind, we've got to look at that first turn as a simple extension. It's nice, it's easy. We want to establish balance going into that first turn, so we don't want to be going absolutely 100 miles an hour yet. We want to get good tension, get good feeling, so that we can set up an effective rest of the throw. That second key aspect is we want to establish good stability and good balance. If we're coming out of our winds too aggressively, we are going to be off balance. And when we're off balance, we're going to be falling all over the place. We're going to be struggling to get into that left side as we're pushing from the right side. So we've got to think about establishing good balance in that first turn. Ideally, most right-handed hammer throwers should have their axis of rotation just over the inside of their left foot, inside of their left hip, into their left shoulder. So we want to make sure that we're establishing good balance as we come out of those winds and we enter into that first turn. Finally, we want to focus on establishing that orbit and staying flat. Rudy Winkler describes this as just being on top of the ball and being flat on top of the ball. And that's a really important way to view that first turn. That first turn is about staying flat. It's about establishing that good balance. It's about being an extension out of your winds so that you can set up the rest of the throw. If we have a very effective first turn, now all of a sudden turns two, three, and four are gonna result in a monster bomb. So make sure that you utilize these three key tips. We wanna make sure you're not rushing coming out of the first and second wind. We're establishing a nice, stable, and effective first turn, and that's gonna lead to those big throws. If you want more information about throwing in general, you can click on this card right here. If you want more information about throwing-based training, head over to throwsuniversity.com. Until next time, guys, peace.